What is up, guys? We're back with another video. Damn, has it been a while. Last time I uploaded was almost, I think it was almost like 3 or 4 weeks ago. I'm not quite sure when you guys will be seeing this video. So, yeah, but judging by the title of this video, the only reason I'm really doing this video is just to see how well this video does. If this video does well, I'll do similar videos like this in the future. So, yeah, but this is going to be a showdown live, mainly a showdown live, stuff like that. So, if you guys not know, pretty much, last time I uploaded, I've had, like, no time to upload recently. Work has been killing me. I've had, like, at least, I don't know, I've been, like, slaying, like, work's been, like, slaying me. I've been slaying work, pretty much, for the last couple weeks. Zero time to upload, and then when I do have time to upload, I get home from work, I'm like, well, fuck this shit, because I'm tired as fuck. One thing I want to do is sit down and play some video games, or watch TV, or take a nap, or go to bed, sleep for the next day. It's like, fuck this shit, honestly. There's been, like, zero Pokemon news, nothing for me to go over. It is absolutely dead right now. The only thing else I'm going to be uploading for you guys is going to be a Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee game giveaway. I will be giving you guys a game or a free giveaway as well. Again, sometime in this month, I'll be throwing that video up. But probably the reason why most of you clicked on this video, MrBeast. MrBeast. Now, this is not any hate towards MrBeast. If you guys don't know MrBeast, MrBeast is actually a YouTuber. He has like 7 million subs. He does this wacky shit where he like proves, he does like experiments and shit, like random shit on his channel. This is no way a hate video towards MrBeast. I like his content. I think his channel is very, very cool. I usually watch his videos whenever I can. The only things, by the title of this video, which is probably going to be a critique of MrBeast. If you guys don't know what a critique is, MrBeast, critique is pretty much something that he can change to make his videos a lot better. It's not that he has to do it, it's just in my personal opinion. I think the thing that makes his videos really bad and that things I don't like about his videos, one, he promotes too much of his merch. His merch is not the greatest merch. I can find a better shirt at the thrift store than going on his site and purchasing a shirt for, I think it's like 20 or 30 bucks when the shirt only costs like $2 to make. So he's making 100% markup on the shirts. They're not even that great of designs. He constantly plugs them throughout his videos. Really, really, really annoying. And the other thing I think that he needs to change, he needs to quit plugging his merch so often throughout his videos. The only place he should be plugging is the end of his videos or in the description. He's that big of a channel to where people are going to be always looking at the description. You don't need to plug it throughout the video. It's not like the designs are like great or anything. The designs are actually really bad. Like I said, you can find a better looking shirt at the thrift store than buying a shirt for like 20 or 30 bucks off his website that he makes 150% markup on. Again, not hating towards him. It's just a critique is stuff that he can possibly change to make his videos better. And the second thing that I think he can change his videos, most of his videos, you go to most of his videos on his channel, they're mostly filler. What I mean by filler is pretty much, we're going to go to his channel right now. This video right here, for example, this actually was uploaded a little while ago. Like half of this video was filler, honestly. He's shooting sponges, he's shooting wood with a 50 cal, he's shooting glass. We did not come to the video to see you shoot glass and shoot all these random objects and shit like that. You may think it's funny, but a lot of your people don't think it's funny. The reason why we click on the video is to see the 50 cal bullet go through 1 million Legos. We didn't come to see you shoot a sponge. We didn't come to see you shoot a wooden pellet. We didn't come to see you shoot your iPhone. We did not see that shit. Thank God there is a skip, or there's like a time bar to where you can skip throughout the video. Otherwise, that would be a huge complaint. It's not that bad, just because I always skip that part and skip like to the point where he's doing what the video it states pretty much. This here, this this thumbnail. He does a lot of stuff in his videos as well, just so he has thumbnails so he can kind of clickbait, which I really don't agree with. Yeah, whatever. That's all I'm really gonna talk about. I just want to see how this video does. Again, this is no hate towards him. This is just some things and some constructive criticism. Just for him. I doubt he'll even see this video. If he does, then props to you, bro. This is not a hate video. I like your videos. Your channel's great. Whatever. But just some stuff that I think you can fix that a lot of people, especially our audience. I'm not the only one that thinks this, that can improve your videos greatly, you know, and amount to you making even more money than you are now and allowing you to get even more views. So now technically this video is not misleading. I know I'm gonna have somebody in the comment section, "Oh, Brad's uploading Showdown Lives and stating and calling out bigger YouTubers and putting bigger YouTubers in the title to get views." This is not a misleading video. I did talk about MrBeast in this video, so if anybody wants to state that this is a misleading video, please try me. What else? Yeah, this is going to be a Showdown Live. I'm going to be honest with you guys, this is the first time I've been on Showdown in, since like whenever I did that Zero Aura video, when I went on Showdown with Zero Aura, which I think was like 3 or 4 months ago now. I have not played Pokemon since. I have not played a single match of Pokemon since then. This team I kind of just threw together. I just got to be careful because AIM might actually coincidentally have the same sets as me again. So, anyways, got MrBeast, Guzzlord again. I'm not going to really go into this detail. I've honestly spent way too much time putting this team together when I probably should just pick shit out and put shit together for this video. Got Garbodor, there's Spike Setter, we got Vegavolt, just because I want to use Vegavolt for some reason. Blastoise is a Rapid Spinner, got Choice Scarf Skok, and we got Subseed, Whimsicott, whatever. Again, I just threw this team together just for this video. I don't expect to get a single win with this team. I'm only going to be doing one match in this video, so I'm just going to be talking about stuff that's been going on lately and stuff related to the channel just because I haven't been able to upload a lot lately. My opponent has Archeops, Sandslash, Hitmontop, Jellicent, Vileplume, and Incineroar. How far are we in, actually? I'm 7 minutes in already, holy shit. It's probably going to be like a 20-minute video. Guzzlord actually destroys this guy's team if I can get rid of the Incineroar. He really doesn't have too much. I guess maybe Hitmontop if I can get rid of that. With Blastoise, predicting Archeops as he does. YOLO. If he goes out into Jellicent, I really don't care. Again, I'm not even trying to win these matches. I just trying to do this to see how this video does. So, he does go into Jellicent. What a sweat. Wish I had Toxic here, but I didn't put Toxic on this set because I have Toxic Spikes, Garbodor. Maybe should have did that. Oh well. I mean, realistically, what does he have to switch into a Draco? He has no switch into a Draco whatsoever. I just click Draco, pretty much. And I could pretty much just nuke something here. Anyways, talking about the channel, like I said, work's been slaying me, the reason why I really haven't been able to do anything on my channel. So, if you guys want more content, then I'm going to need to at least get 1,000 subs so I can start making at least a little bit of money as motivation, as a reason to get on here and start making videos, or a Patreon, which I haven't had time to really set up, and I don't even think anybody's, I haven't even had anybody come to me and say that they would even support me on there anyways, so even if I do make one, it might just be a waste of time if I don't get anybody's support. So let me know in the comment section down below, would you support me on Patreon? That'd be great. Even if it's like $1 a month, it's better than nothing, and it will make me be motivated to make videos and give me a reason to make videos. Alright, so, I don't know, I really don't want to stay in here. He's really weakened. I pretty much come in and click Draco every time on something, so. Uh, Also, another thing I've actually kind of want to do is actually set up maybe like a GoFundMe or like a donation thing. If you guys do not know, I have like so many people complaining to me on my videos. Oh, Brad, your audio quality sounds like shit, bro. Why is your video so laggy, bro? Why are your videos so low quality, bro? People do not know. I've said this in like multiple videos in the past. So if you've been on the video on my channel for a long time, you already know this. I'm on a computer from 2005. 2005. So if you want to go in the comment section down below and bitch and complain how my audio quality is or my video quality, then you should be the person that's giving me money to fund a new computer for me. So if you're gonna go in the comment section and bitch and moan, please open your wallet and give me some money so I can buy a new computer and then I can make you happy, please. Or at least buy a new mic or something if you want to bitch and complain. Usually most people in the comment section down below that are actually complaining about it as well seem like they have a lot of money. So if they have a lot of money, please open your wallet and give some to me, because I can really use it. I'm broke as fuck. What's this thing even gonna do to me, honestly? What is it even gonna do? And I just have people in the comment section, oh, Brad is an e-bagger, man. Brad is an e-bagger. He does nothing but ask people for money, blah, blah, blah. You put yourself in my shoes, and people want videos from you, and people expect you to upload. You have a YouTube channel you had for at least like 3.5 years, 3+ years now, I think it is, and you've been uploading consistently to the point where you're almost in your mid-20s now. Well, I'm not even close to my mid-20s, actually. I'm just starting in my 20s, but, pretty much. And then people expect videos from you, and then you have shit to pay. I have rent to pay, I have car bills, I have like insurance and shit to pay. I have other shit to pay, food, you gotta buy yourself food, I have rent, like I said, rent, I have to pay for gas, a lot of other shit to pay for, so. Is there any way I can turn this timer off? Can I not turn this timer off, really? You asshole. I mean, I'm probably just gonna set up stuff here, honestly. What was I saying? Oh, some shit. Oh, yeah, people think I'm an e-bagger. And then they expect me to make videos, but I have to work. I have all these bills to pay because I'm on my own now, and I'm, like I said, I'm in my 20s now, so I have all these bills to pay, and then people think, oh, Brad's an e-bagger because he wants to get to 1,000 subs so he can make a little bit of money off YouTube. Oh, he wants to make a Patreon, blah blah blah. And I have all the same. It's pretty much the same thing as the people that are actually complaining that my videos suck and like quality is so bad. If you want me to make better videos, I don't have money to put into this, honestly. If you want me to make better videos, the only way I'm going to be able to make better videos is if I make money off my videos, like whatever it is. Or if I make like a couple cents if I get to 1,000 subs. If I make a Patreon, or if I make like a GoFundMe or like a donation thing where people can give me money to fund a new computer, a new mic, a new whatever, like an Elgato so I can stream stuff from my Switch, anything like that, whatever. That's not the reason why I'm asking for money. I can make my own money, I can pay my own rent. The reason why I'm asking for money, or people always seem to want money, is because I want to upgrade my stuff. People always give shit, giving me shit that my quality and shit is always so bad, but then they're the people that don't want to give me money and think I'm an e-pegger just because I want to make my content better. Whatever. It's not like I'm going to be buying a new computer soon anyways. The next thing I'm actually planning on buying, I'm driving a literally like 19-year-old car right now. Not that it's bad, it's a great car, but I would eventually like to upgrade here with the next like year or two. So I'm currently saving up to get a newer vehicle just because I need it for my work. I work I think like almost 15 miles out of town, 15 miles out of town and 15 miles back pretty much like every day. So I kind of need something that's at least, I mean, my car right now isn't bad. It's a great car, it's well maintained, whatever. But just kind of want something new, or I kind of want to upgrade. So that's the reason why I'm not going to be putting any money into this. I ain't making any money from this. The car at least is going to help me in real life. If I save up money and buy a new computer, what am I legitimately getting out of this? What am I legitimately getting? It's not like I'm making money off this. It's more beneficial for me to buy a car and upgrade my vehicle than spending money on a brand new computer or a new laptop. So, whatever. Just some shit I wanted to get off my shoulders, because I know a lot of people, there's been so many comments lately. Like I said, oh, Brad, your quality, your video suck, blah, blah, blah. All this shit, your video quality sucks, your audio quality sucks, blah, blah, blah. Again, my computer's from 2005. I don't even know what else I need to say. I'm probably gonna lose this, honestly. I don't even know why I'm trying to make decisions here, because I'm for sure probably gonna lose this. Just kill that YOLO bug buzz. This match is probably gonna go way beyond what it's supposed to go. Can I get the spidef drop, please? And he just takes me out, okay. Whatever. Now I can go into Bobby Lashley. And wreck some people. It's two weak things at this point. I just need something to clean up. Bobby Lashley's gonna clean this up for us. I still probably lose because I have no check now for... I mean, I have really nothing for this thing, if he recovers up. I outspeed him, so... Switches out, he's dead to spikes, unless he gets rid of spikes somehow. His Hitmon top is dead if he comes in. Unless he goes out into Sand Slash here, which I don't think he would do. If he does, then he's a baller. Like I said, this is the first match I've played since like that Zero Aura video went up, the last Showdown Live. So, I have not played a single match since then. So, being that said, I think I'm doing at least decent. He's gonna try getting rid of these rocks. These spikes. I mean, realistically, I go into Guzzlord and I click Draco, right? Realistically, that's what I do. I go into Guzzlord and I click Draco. What's your switch in? Can you please make a move? I mean, why he's trying to make a move, I don't know what else I can really talk about. There's not really much else to really say, honestly. Like I said, I know I haven't been uploading, whatever. I've talked about that throughout this entire video. The reasons why I haven't been uploading, work's been slaying me. Whatever. It only did 39%, really? Wow. Now he has no vile plume to switch in though. I think there's actually a losing war for me because he can just recover up. He's getting a lot more back than I am. Because he goes for recover here. I stop. He has to recover. Wow, he does not even recover, okay. How do you live that, dude? He just wants his thing gone. Ganai's come in right here. Should have predicted that. Got rid of his assault vest. He's actually running Super Fang Sand Slash. Alright, whatever, dude. Does he go out in a jealous in here? I think he does. Yeah, he does. We made that correct prediction. Again, what do you have to switch into a Draco here? I'm just gonna go for the Dark Pulse because he doesn't have the best Dark Pulse switch-ins. Also, another thing. Hopefully, guys, if you guys are new and you made it this far somehow, then please subscribe down below, that'd be great. I have a goal of 1,000 subs before Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee does get released, or I released it. So hopefully we can get that far. I'm pretty sure I just lose at this point. I don't know why I'm even playing this. Because, I'm just gonna forfeit because it's not worth my time. As long as he has Jellicent around, and, full health Archeops, which outspeeds me, I think. If he's max speed, he would outspeed me, even if I am Scarf, so I think I still lose either way, so YOLO. Apologize if you guys were looking for the end of that match, but I honestly don't even want to go on. Because I kinda know I was getting ready to lose. Does it really matter? No. Because I really don't give a shit. The only reason I'm doing this video again, like I said, is because I want to see how this video does. If this video does do well, which I hope it does, I will do a similar video like this in the future, hopefully. I'll just put, like, Showdown Lives, but I'll make it, like, half Showdown Live, half whatever. Something different, whatever. Whatever I did for this video, at least. So, yeah. If you guys are new, subscribe. Again, like I said, I'm going to have a Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee game, Switch game giveaway here, probably sometime after this video goes up, probably like in the next week or two, so stay tuned for that. And yeah, 100% free game, so if you guys want a free game, then by all means enter that giveaway, that'd be great. Apart from that, not really too much else to go over. I'll see you guys in a future video. What else was I gonna say? I was gonna say one more thing. Fuck, what was it? Oh yeah, another thing I've actually kind of been frustrated with as well, and that's kind of demotivating me from uploading. My videos went from, I was getting like at least 500, I'd say like around 200 to 500 views per video, like legit like a month or and a half ago, and now my videos aren't even getting promoted anymore. The last video I uploaded only has like 60 views, so when it should at least have like almost 250 views by now. The videos I were uploading like legit like a month and a half ago, within the first 48 hours they had like 150 views, which was absolutely insane. I don't know if YouTube is quitting promoting my videos again, or if my videos aren't hitting sub boxes, I don't know. I kind of think it's my videos aren't hitting sub boxes, because I have had a few people that are bringing it up to me that are saying that my videos ain't appearing in the sub box. So if that's the case, then YouTube sucks. So I recommend you hit that bell and the notification thing down below by the subscribe button. That'd be great. And that actually really just helped me out. If not, if YouTube's not promoting my videos anymore, I don't know why. Again, kind of just demotivates me. I was getting 200 to like 500 views per video, like a legit like a month and a half ago, and now I'm back to down like less than 100 views. Really a demotivator for not making me want to upload, honestly, just because I'm putting all this work into these videos, and it's not really doing anything for me. So, whatever. Just wanted to say that before I end the video. Now I'm out. See you guys, and then whenever I upload again. Peace.